السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى All praise due to Allah and that's sufficient you say Alhamdulillah suffice you say Alhamdulillah It's enough. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَىٰ And peace be upon all his slaves and his servants that he chose them, the messengers and the head of them, our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, الَّذِي أَدَّى الْأَمَانَ وَبَلَّغَ الرِّسَالَ وَنَصَحَ الْأُمَّ وَكَشَفَ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْغُمَّةِ That he conveyed the message and he completed his Amana, he fulfilled his trust, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he advised the ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarified with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam everything. Taraktukum ala al-mahajjati al-bayda layluha kanahariha. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I left you for like with white sheet. Layluha kanahariha. It is night like this day, that everything is clear and being described by Rasulullah and being explained by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He made sure that he complete his message to the extent that he gathered all thousands of people before he died. He said to them, Allaah hal ballaghd, Allaah hal ballaghd. All of them, they said, yes. He said, did I convey the message? Did I convey the message? Thousands of people, all of them, they said, yes, you conveyed the message. He said, Allahumma fashhad, O Allah, be a witness. O Allah, is my witness. And he passed away, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to resurrect us on his jannah, inshallah, with Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his level of al-jannah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is why we have to strive hard. We have to work hard to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nothing, there is no any way brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala other than the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُقَرِّبُنَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَىٰ Brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we meet our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm sorry, the lesson yesterday is not posted because we have net connection problems. But inshallah, I will try to review what I have said yesterday, inshallah, for those who are not here, so they can benefit. Because I believe a lot of brothers and sisters, they wait until the lesson. Because this time is very tough time for us, almost iftar time, sisters are cooking, brothers are shopping and all these things. So, but we don't have no choice, we have to make it on this time, inshallah ta'ala. For those who are available, welcome. And for those who are not here, inshallah, you can watch this later, inshallah ta'ala. So, we have said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yajtahid. في العشر أي العشر الأواخر فما لم يجتهد في غيره and the hadith all the, most of the hadith or majority of these hadith narrated by عائشة رضي الله عنها in البخاري and Muslim so all the hadith we're going to mention narrated by عائشة رضي الله عنها من البخاري ومسلم ومتفق عليه يعني authentic hadith she said رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to strive hard On this last 10 days of Ramadan, days and nights, especially the nights. ما لم يجتهد في غيره. He used to strive more than he used to strive any other nights. And of course, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to pray the whole nights. As we mentioned, he used to pray every night. But in this night, he has more concern on it. To the extent that what? He goes and make i'tikaf, stay in the masjid, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the other hadith, narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha, قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أحيى الليل وأيقظ أهله وجد وشد المئزر. متفق عليه البخاري ومسلم. In the other narration, she said, when the last 10 days, she talked about more details here, how he used to strive. So by what? أحيى الليل. أحيى, like, stand praying at night, doing a lot of different things without sleeping. Because when we said death, sleep, al-mawtu, al-nawmu akhu al-mawt, we call death and sleep is brothers, you know. And death is the major and the sleep is the minor death. So by saying ahya, like give the night haya, like he didn't sleep. So he didn't used to sleep at night, the whole night, and or maybe majority of the night, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's ahya al-layl. Wa ayqadha ahlahu. Ayqadha ahlahu. Ayqadha ahlahu. Kana sallallahu alayhi wa sallam haris. Haris kull al-hirs ala ayqad ahlihi. Kull zawjat kullahum. He used to like really, you know, care about waking up his family. Why? Because we are in charge. The person, the believer in charge, we are in charge of our families. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'oolun an ra'iyatihi. Yani, ayqadh ahlahu dilala ala anna al-insan yahtam bi salah, la yahtam bi salahi nafsihi faqat, bal ma'mur bi salahi ghayrihi. وأقرب الغير هم الأهل. So the person who is not in charge of himself only, he's in charge of others. And the most closest others, your family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم. ما معنى قوا؟ يعني وقاية. تعمل وقاية لنفسك من النار. كيف تعمل وقاية لنفسك من النار؟ تعمل وقاية لنفسك من غضب الجبار. ما تعمل أشياء تغضب الله سبحانه وتعالى، ولا تعمل أشياء حرام تدخلك إلى النار إذا قبضت عليها، لأن هناك في ملائكة تكتب، الملائكة دائما معنا تكتب الحسنات والسيئات. والملائكة تكون معك وقت الموت، والملائكة تأتيك في القبر، والملائكة تأتيك في الحشر، والملائكة تكون في الصراط، والملائكة تكون على النار، خزنة جهنم العياذ بالله. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, save yourself and your family from a fire. It is fuel from what? The fuel of the fire, what? Men, people and stones. وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها. On it, who's in charge of the fire? ملائكة غلاظ شداد. Angels, tough, strong and big. Nobody can, you know, get on their business. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to do, لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم. Take this person in the fire, they will take you and drag you in the hellfire. ويفعلون ما يؤمرون أي يزجون الناس على وجوههم وذوقوا مس سقر. يزجون الناس في جهنم قل ذوقوا مس سقر. So the angels with us writing our deeds. The angels will come when we die. The angels will come in the grave, they ask us. The angels will stand, when we're standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they come and ask us. And then the angels are standing on the hellfire. The angels are in charge, Malik. The people of the fire, they said, Ahlul Nar yaqulu, قالوا يا مالك ادع لنا ربك يخفف علي يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب. Subhanallah. They say, Ya Malik, please call your Lord. Tell him, just, you know, to decrease the punishment. Make it easy for us even one day. We need break. No. There's no way. No break in the fire. Azab, 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 azab. Al-iyaz billah. So this is why when we think about this, يعني عندما نفتكر هذا العذاب, نفكر في أهلنا. نفكر في أهلنا. الإنسان مأمور بإصلاح أهله وما في شيء ينجينا من العذاب وينجينا من غضب الله وينجينا من النار إلا الصلاح إلا عمل الصالحات. يعني الإنسان يقول خلاص تبت إلى الله ويعمل صالح, يعمل حاجات صالحة تقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. هذا هو هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني أرسل لكي ينقذنا من النار. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسل لكي ينقذنا من النار صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهو بيّن, الرسول بيّن لنا الطريق الذي ينقذنا من النار ويدخلنا الجنة. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم has been sent to save us from the hellfire, to take us from the darkness to the light, يخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور ومن النار إلى الجنة. وإن شاء الله يكون معنا صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى في يوم القيامة. He will be with us until the day of judgment. He will intercede for us صلى الله عليه وسلم. يشفع لنا يوم القيامة يخرجنا من النار صلى الله عليه وسلم. ويسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا ندخل النار صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلس يعني خلينا نفكر كيف الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم علمنا وكيف كان يفعل في العشر الأواخر. كان يتحرى ليلة القدر صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني كان جدة strived hard وأيقظ أهله and he woke up all his family وأحيى الليل and he stand the whole night worshiping Allah سبحانه وتعالى وشد المئزر. And he untied, or just, you know, like he tied his izar. Al-izar huwa ma yughatta bihi asfal al-jism lil-rajul. Al-izar, whatever that we cover, the bottom of our body, from the belly button to the down, thus we call it izar. So he used to tie that one. As we said, the ulama, they said, why he used to tie? What's that means? Tying his izar, that means he's, يعني كان يعتزل أهله. He used to stay away from his wives, his women. He doesn't go to any, spend night on any one of them. وشد الإزار أيضا الدلالة على الاجتهاد في العبادة. يعني معناها أنه يترك الأهل وأيضا يشد, يعني شد الحيل. عندنا في البلاد يقول لك شد حيلك, يعني خلاص تتشد وخلاص تكون ايه قوي وتتحمل. لانه عباده الليل ليست سهله, الصلاه في الليل ليست سهله, الذكر في الليل يغلبك النوم وتغلبك الشهوات, ولكن الانسان يصبر. So this is why they said he used to strive hard, because the worship at night is difficult. It's not easy. Especially for someone who is not used to it, you know. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to strive hard more than the other days. He used to pray, but in this, he used to pray the whole night until his feet got swollen. يعني كان يقيم الليل حتى تفطرت قدماه. لكن في العشر الأواخر من رمضان صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يجتهد أكثر وأكثر وأكثر ويعتكف في المسجد. So he used to strive more and more and harder, and he used to spend the time at the masjid. This is why we have to think about ourselves, inshallah, الله سبحانه وتعالى ينجينا من النار نسأل الله ينجينا كلنا من النار وأهلنا كلهم من النار ومن غضب الجبار سبحانه وتعالى نجتهد حتى نرضي الله سبحانه وتعالى يرضى عننا في الأيام في العشر الأواخر نستغفر الله يا الله اغفر لي يا الله أنا ما عملت أي أشياء يعني ممكن تدخلني الجنة يا الله أنت تعلم أنا عبد ضعيف you talk to Allah سبحانه وتعالى Allah loves the slave when the slave come to Allah سبحانه وتعالى in this way Allah يحب العبد اللحوح العبد اللحوح الذي يلح في الدعاء يا الله اغفر لي يا الله أنت تعلم أنا عملت كذا وكذا وكذا يا الله أنت الغفور الرحيم إن شاء الله أنا خلاص إن شاء الله حبد الصلاة من بعد رمضان ده ما حأخلي الصلاة إن شاء الله يعني أنا حاجتهد وأعمل وأعمل الله سبحانه وتعالى يرى ما في قلبك ويرى نيتك وعزيمتك So Allah سبحانه وتعالى He looks into your heart and He will see your niyyah your intention and how hard you want to be closer to Allah Allah will bring you closer to Him لكن أنت تقول أنا أدعو الله وعايز يعني إن شاء الله أصلي بعد رمضان بعد العيد خلاص أرجع للذنوب والمعاصي وأرجع للإجرام وأرجع لكذا سبحان الله كيف يتوب الله سبحانه وتعالى لأن الله يعلم الله يعلم درجة الإخلاص في قلبك فتوب إلى الله توبة نصوحة لله سبحانه وتعالى وأبدأ الليلة خلاص إن شاء الله يعني سبحان الله سنقضي بمشيئة الله سبحانه وتعالى ما هي إلا دقائق ما هي إلا دقائق وخلاص تبدأ العشر الأواخر We have just only few minutes and we're going to start the 10 nights. This is the time. هذا هو الوقت الذي يحبه الله سبحانه وتعالى. That's the time that Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves this time. الله يحب ذاك الوقت. لماذا؟ لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يحب الدعاء. الله يحب الدعاء. عشان الناس كلها تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى وتجتهد فالله سبحانه وتعالى يغفر لهم. ويرضى عنهم ويتوب عليهم ويوفقهم إلى عمل الخيرات So people they strive on these nights As much as you can The best thing you can do like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam But I'm not going to tell you you have to do like them No as much as you can يعني بقدر المستطاع تعمل شيء في هذه الليالي تفتح المصحف تقرأ القرآن تصلي الله سبحانه وتعالى تذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى تجلس في المصلاية وتستغفر الله سبحانه وتعالى استغفر الله العظيم تندم على ما فعلته تندم على أنك ما فعلت أشياء في رمضان يعني صيام يمكن ما صمت كويس أو في الصيام جرحت صيامك أو ما قمت الليل ما عملت سبحان الله تندم على ذلك وتستغفر الله سبحانه وتعالى والله هو الغفور الرحيم الله يحب ذلك الله loves these 10 last 10 nights in the month of Ramadan so كان يعتكف صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى توفاه الله سبحانه وتعالى في رمضان ما ترك الاعتكاف في العشر الأواخر حتى مات صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to make اعتكاف stay in the masjid and spend these 10 nights until he passed away صلى الله عليه وسلم. He never stopped. So this is why we say القيام الليل والاعتكاف وصلاة الليل وقيام ليلة القدر هذه هي سنة مؤكدة. Something has been confirmed with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He never left it and he never stopped until he passed away. So we try to do that and wake up your family, your children, and Subhanallah. Nuh alayhi salam. Subhanallah. You see, this is the sunnah of the Anbiya. Nuh alayhi salam. He was concerning about his son to the last minute of his life. يعني كان يدعو ولده ويقول يا بني تعال اركب معنا يا ابني اركب معنا انت ولا تكن من الكافرين يا ابني انت من اهلي لازم يعني انا عايز انجيك من النار كيف تدخل النار وكذا يا بني تعال اركب معنا ولا تكن مع الكافرين وابنه قال له سآوي الى جبل يعصمني من الماء وابنه كفر قال لا ما سمع لأبوه وكذا لحد ما سبحان الله ابنه أخذ بالطوفان. Allah destroy the city and he took his son in punishment with them. نوح عليه السلام قال رب ابني من أهلي ووعدك الحق وأنت أرحم الراحمين. يا الله. Oh, see the father. He said, oh Allah, oh my Lord, my son is from my family. And he promised that you will give me good things. And you are the most merciful. Ya Allah. That means he's begging Allah to be mercy upon his son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala lahu innahu laysa min ahlik. He's not from your family. Innahu amila ghayra salih. And in the Quran, two narrations. Innahu amalun ghayru salih. وَإِنَّهُ عَمِلَ غَيْرُ صَالِحٍ. He's not good deed. And he did something. And the other narration means that he was not doing good by disobeying you and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He died as a disbeliever and there is no way he's not going to be saved from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was begging his uncle. His uncle like his father, because he's the one who raised him after his grandfather passed away, his father passed away. Who raised Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Abu Talib, his uncle, and he's the closest one to him. And he protected him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was concerning until the last, he's on the bed dying. Ya ammi, qul kalima, uhajju laka biha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah. كلمة تنجيك من النار وتدخلك الجنة. Oh my uncle, say a word so I can intercede for you in the day of judgment in front of Allah. Say a word to save you from the hellfire and enter you الجنة. And then he said, على ملة عبد المطلب. He said, I'm going to die, you know, with the nation of my people, the religion of my my forefathers. Allahu Akbar. And he passed away. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, my uncle, because what he did, but he died kafir, but he's still in hellfire. He went to the hellfire. Allahu Akbar. And he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him minor punishment because he was not a hypocrite. He was supporting the Muslims. And he was supporting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until he passed away. So what's his minor punishment? Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينجينا من النار. يعني ما هذا أقل عذاب. What's the minor punishment? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah make sleepers for him, sleepers from hellfire, that his brain is boiling from the heat of that sleepers. Imagine shoes from the fire, his brain is boiling. That means he's in this punishment. He's still in the hellfire. Allahu Akbar. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يدخلنا النار. نسأل الله يبعدنا عن النار ويدخلنا الجنة. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى not to enter us the hellfire and take us away from the hellfire and enter us the الجنة. And what's the best thing that you takes you away from the hellfire? الصوم fasting. When you are fasting, you are not doing. Don't even imagine. You're not doing something easy. Don't waste this fasting by talking badly or acting badly while you are fasting. You're doing something dear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine if you're fasting sunnah or you're fasting fard. And try to make intention inshallah to be among those people who are fasting. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, man sama yawman. Forget about a month. Just one day. Yawman fi sabilillah. You fast one day seeking the pleasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بعد الله بينه وبين النار سبعين خريفا. Allah يباعد بينك وبين النار سبعين خريف. Allah will make a distance between you and hellfire 70 years distance between you and fire. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst الصائمين. So you are fasting. أنت صائم اليوم صائم ال خلال اليوم وقائم في الليل. You are fasting the day and standing, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praying at night. You think Allah is not going to forgive you? Allahu Akbar. Allah promised Yeah. Allah promised. You seek forgiveness from Allah, He will forgive you. He promised. You make sincere dua to Allah, Allah will give it to you. So ask Allah, say Allah, Allahumma la tahrimni ru'yat wajhaka fil jannah. Oh Allah, please do not deprive me to see your face in Jannah, ya Allah. Please do not deprive me, please do not take me away from my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. You think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to accept? You're fasting the day. And then at night you're begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. Allahumma inni a'mal salihan. Oh Allah, help me to do good deeds. I was not doing much. I was not doing good. I made a lot of mess in my life. I'm not doing. Please, Allah, help me to do more. To do good deeds. So you can please. You can be pleased on me when I die. Ya Allah, I'm not going to accept nowhere. I don't want to go nowhere other than al-Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said what? Is'alullah al-Jannah. Was'alullah al-ula min al-Jannah. Ask Allah the highest level of al-Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. We need to be with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my brothers and sisters. We have to be with him. Subhanallah, imagine Allah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala included you with these people, that they will be with Prophet, they'll be in the company of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we are lazy and we sleep and we're not praying much, we're not prostrating to Allah, we're not making dua, and then we let these 10 days or 10 nights of Ramadan just leave. Wallahi, I'm so sad, but alhamdulillah, that's the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I see a lot of brothers and sisters in our community, they are really, mashallah, they love Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the proof for that? What's the proof for that? I received a lot of phone calls because they have my phone number with the mothers and the parents of the students. So my number is out there. A lot of phone calls from the brothers and some phone calls from the sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect you and enter you al-Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallah, I'm thinking of that, subhanallah. These brothers, they're calling me, brother, the masjid is open for the last 10 nights. Masjid is open for the last 10 nights. Sisters, they ask, Do you need any food? The masjid is open. We can cook some food for i'tikaf, for Allahu Akbar. I love you, brothers. I love you. You're living in America in this society and with all these bad things and subhanAllah, all these deceiving. You are concerning about to come and spend the night and make the i'tikaf and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abshiru. Wallah, you have glad tidings. I'm so glad. And you have glad tidings for that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter you al-Jannah. And for those brothers and sisters, do not be lazy. You have to be like these. You have to concern like these others. Those who are calling day and night asking, is the masjid open the last 10? We say to them, no. There's only one masjid. You can go to, you can, you know. And we direct them to some places so they can go and spend the nights over there. Please, brothers and sisters, if you are in Jannah, inshallah, ask for me. Ask brothers, tell them, this brother, he was advising us, inshallah, you know, because I don't know where I'm going to go, you know. I don't know where I'm going to go, to hell or to Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter us to paradise with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's what we call it, ijtihad. Ijtihad. Rasulullah jadda. Ijtihad. Subhanallah, Aisha radiallahu anha, she doesn't have to say that. But she's saying that because she saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to strive hard. He used to strive hard in this last. He doesn't have no any time, even for his family. Allahu Akbar. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Seeking Laylatul Qadri. He's seeking لَيْتَحَرَّي لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. Even in the authentic hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, تحروا ليلة القدر في الوتر, في الليالي الوتر. في الوتر من العشر الأواخر. تحروا ليلة القدر في الوتر من العشر. He said, look for ليلة القدر and seek ليلة القدر in the odd nights of the 10 days. This is authentic hadith. It's not bad. It's not bad. We don't say to the brothers or sisters, they want just to pray the odd nights, because they take this hadith. It's narrated by Aisha and is in Muslim. And Sahih Muslim, Sahih, hadith Sahih. You know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you can seek the night, the odd nights. So if you're working, you're busy, you can just spend the odd nights. Even if you didn't pray the other one, the odd night, don't waste it. This odd night, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, definitely the Laylatul Qadr maybe is going to be one of these odd nights. The 21st, 22nd, I mean the 21st, the 23rd, the 25th, and the 27th. And there's another hadith for the 27th. You know, Laylatul Qadr maybe is going to be on the 27th. So don't miss that time. And don't miss to pay sadaqah in these 10 days or these nights. Don't miss to pay sadaqah. This is a call for everybody. Why? Because نحن في أواخر الخير أواخر شهر رمضان. We are in the last part of the month of Ramadan. And always the last is good. The last, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنما الأعمال تؤخذ بالخواتيم. Our deeds, the best of our deeds, that when we do it on important. It's very important for us to strive hard and then take the odd nights. Do not sleep in these nights. Some brothers and sisters, they say, brother, we don't know much Quran. I know only ikhlas, qul huwa Allah wa'ad, qul a'uzu bi rabbi nas. No, you can pray as much as you can, repeat al-ikhlas. Allahu Akbar, recite al-Fatiha and al-ikhlas, and then do it again. Do al-ikhlas if you know qul huwa Allahu ahad. Don't say, oh, I don't know how I can pray. No. Now, the masjid is not open, but your house is a masjid. Your house is masjid for you. Allahu Akbar, you recite al-Fatiha, qul huwa Allahu ahad for the 11th rak'ah. Or maybe the whole night, just keep reciting qul huwa Allahu ahad. And then take a part, make dua, beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the night. And take a part from the night, read the Quran translation, reflect. Subhanallah, some brothers, mashallah, and sisters, when they read the Quran, even in English, you can see the tears. They subhanallah, because it affects their iman. When they read it and they understand it, they understand it. Subhanallah, one day I was leading the salah over here, this brother was crying loud. I was, subhanallah, after the salah, I said to him, brother, like, what's going on? Like, tell me, why are you crying? Like, he said, I'm not crying because I understand what you are saying. I'm crying because you're reciting the Quran with beautiful voice and I don't understand one word from what you are saying. This is why I'm crying. I said to him, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. Allah will accept from you. So, like, you open the Quran in English. When you pass through ayah, has istighfar, you seek forgiveness and reflect about it. Read it with your own language and reflect about it. This is ibadah too. The only way you cannot read the Quran in English while you are praying. But you have time. You are at night standing, praying to Allah, remembering Allah, asking forgiveness. If you don't know the dua in Arabic, make the dua with your own language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows all the languages. And He will, what? He will, He knows. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond unto you. But don't let the shaitan play with you. These not nights of play. هذه ليست أيام لعب وليست ليالي لعب وليست ليالي نوم وليست ليالي راحة. This night is not nights of play, not night of wasting your time on TV or games or whatever that you do, not night of wasting your time even with your family. Allahu Akbar. Not night to waste your time with anything, only to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not nights of sleeping. You cannot even, subhanAllah, I'm not saying that one is an obligation upon you. I'm not saying it's an obligation. ولكن كما قال الإمام النووي رحمة الله عليه but الإمام النووي said you know these nights قيامها مستحبا استحبابا شديدا أو مستحبا استحبابا كثيرا وصيام يوم عرفة مستحب استحباب شديد. He said the last 10 nights or these nights of Ramadan, last 10 nights is more dear Allah. They said this, Allah loves these nights so much. Allah loves these nights. And same thing like you're fat. Why? Because you're seeking forgiveness. And Allah, the other thing that Allah loves so much, the Yawm Arafah. It's not, this. All this is not fard. It's not an obligation upon anybody to do. But for those who loves Allah and they want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do the best, Allah, the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So, day of Arafah too. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will look to the people in Arafah standing on that mountain or those who are fasting during the day. And He will say, I forgive all of you. All of you have been forgiven. Allahu Akbar. So imagine you are in the last 10 night and then you are in Laylatul Qadri. Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alf shahr. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this night is better than 1,000 months. 80 something years. That means better than your whole age. Your whole life. One night is better than your whole night. Allah, of your whole life. Are you going to waste it? Subhanallah. You going to sleep in that? One night. If you pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you stand this night praying or remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or doing something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your previous sins. All your previous sins. Allahu Akbar. Ma taqaddama min zambihi. Allahu Akbar. Whatever that you did in your life. So like you're going to start new page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that. Some people, they say, oh, I don't know how I can read from the phone. I can read the Quran from the phone. For those who knows Arabic, you can read the Quran standing, read it from your phone. You can read the Quran from your small mushaf. You can put the Quran in front of you, stand and pray and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the sunnah, salah, you can hold the mushaf and read. You're praying, hold it and pray. No. You be the imam of your family. Lead your family to good. And talk to them, tell them this is very important. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from His anger, from His punishment. So as I said, it's few hours from now, like subhanAllah, few hours, we have few minutes. يعني دقائق معدودات وَإِلَّا لَنَأْتِي إِلَى هَذِهِ الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مَنْ قَصَّرَ فَلْيَسْتَدْرِكِ مَنْ قَصَّرَ فَلْيَسْتَدْرِكِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنَ فَلْيُوَاصِلِ. If you're short, you didn't do much. Everybody knows. Everybody knows you himself or knows herself. If you didn't do much, try to catch up. Catch up the goodness. This night of Laylatul Qadr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فيها خير, it has a lot of goodness. من حرم خيرها فقط حرم. Allahu Akbar. Whomsoever been deprived from the goodness of this night, he has been deprived. Your whole life has been deprived from all good. So we need to do as much as we can. Make the intention, inshaAllah ta'ala. You know, make the intention and make the dua. Al-dua, silahu al-mu'min. أكرم شيء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى وأحب شيء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى والدعاء هو العبادة. All our worship for the dua. Dua is the worship. Dua is ibadah. That's the most beloved thing to Allah. You know, as I said, dua includes what? The dhikr. Like when you make dua, you're remembering who? You're remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're begging whom? You're begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لهذا الدعاء سلاح المؤمن. Dua is your weapon as Muslim. That's the dua is our weapon. As mu'mins. Believers, that's our weapon, the dua. Against ourselves, against the shaitan, against the dunya, against everything. تقضى به الحاجات ويشفى به المريض وتفرج به الكرب وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتم. With the dua, all your needs will be fulfilled. Make that dua. Make that sincere dua from your heart. All what you need to do is just raise your hands and make dua to Allah. Oh. We see sometimes we make i'tikaf in the masjid. Some brothers, they are making i'tikaf in the masjid. And they are wasting, like last Ramadan, they're wasting their time to the extent that we have to remind them, brothers, like you came and you left your family, you come here, you're wasting your family, you're wasting your time playing and wasting, you're not even doing anything, talking with each other. So we are in the masjid, we do that. How about the houses? It's a more fitna for us. It's more temptations in the house. And more thing distractions in the house. So this is why I'm warning you. Try to make your house musalla. Make your house a masjid. Stay in your room. Coronavirus kept us in our house. And Ramadan, alhamdulillah, in the last 10 nights, is going to keep us in our rooms, inshallah. And that's something we do with our own will. Closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And imagine something you do it by force, Allah forgives, inshallah. But something you do it with your own will. You prove that you're Muslim. You submitted to Allah. You surrendered yourself to Allah. You did something with your own will. You stay in your room, begging Allah, crying to Allah, praying to Allah, and reading the Quran. And this is the best of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cures people. With the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfills all our needs. With the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove all the hardship, remove the diseases, remove everything and cure everybody, inshallah ta'ala. So this is why we need you. We need you. Be amongst the ummah, be part of the ummah. Make dua for those who are dying. Make dua for those who are striving in hospitals. Make dua for them. Make dua for your own self. And make dua for your family that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save you from the punishment. From that punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the punishment. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى إن أراد بقوم فتنة أن يخرجنا من بينهم غير مفتونين. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if he decide to punish certain people in any land to save us, take us away from any fitna, take us away from any trials, make it easy for us, inshallah ta'ala. Imagine, again, don't forget, inshallah, to make dua for you and your family, and don't forget to waste, and don't forget to spend these nights starting. I'm going to remind again, tonight is the first night. Today is the 20th, and the night start after Maghrib. It's going to be the 21st. And then you pass one day, the odd nights. If you decide to spend the odd nights. But with all this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spent the whole 10 days. He said, seek Laylatul Qadr in the odd nights. But he used to spend the whole 10 days because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the messenger of the Iman. He's the first one who tests the sweetness of the Iman. We are being deprived from testing that sweetness of the Iman. So we need to test that sweetness of the Iman so we can do more to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call, oh, Jibreel, I love so and so. Look at them fasting and praying to me. I love them. I love you. Mention your name. Jibreel will go to the heavens. Allah loves so and so. Make your name to be mentioned on the heavens. Make your name be mentioned by Jibreel alayhi salam. And make your name to be amongst those, all the angels love you, Allahu Akbar. Make your name amongst this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is able to do so. Just make the dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waliyu dhalik wal qadir alayhi. Huwa waliyuna. Allah is wali. Allah is in charge of that and he's able to do so. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yatawallana min indi. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yatawallana min indi. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. You say, oh Allah, I wrong myself. But if you don't forgive me and be mercy upon me, I'm going to be amongst the losers. Or you say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. The whole night. Even if you don't know the Quran, you don't know the Salah, you don't need, just stand the whole night and say, Allahumma innaka afoon, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni, 1,000 times. Say it just, Allahumma innaka afoon, tuhibbul afwa, fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you are the oft forgiver. You love to forgive, so please forgive me. Please forgive me, you say for it the whole night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you and accept your deeds. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enter us in Jannah with those who are righteous and with the believers and with the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfir.